welcome to River Oaks. We're so glad you're here today with us today for the service. And we want to make sure that you feel the opportunity to be able to share and take part and make a comment however you'd like during the course of the broadcast. So also, during the course of this, if you have any prayer requests that you'd like to have answered, you can do that at riveroaksva.org/prayer. And also, if you need a bulletin for following along with what's going on here today, feel free to find that at riveroaksva.org/bulletin. And if you've got kids around that need something to do, feel free to find resources over at riveroaksva.org/children's-links. And then also, if you need any of this stuff during the course of the service, feel free to just scan the QR code on the screen there. And now, please join me in the call to worship. Let's read that now together. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. Though we have been grieved by various trials, we have a sure and steadfast anchor of our souls. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in tribulation. Be constant in prayer. Be strong and let your heart take courage, all you who hope in the Lord. Hope does not disappoint us because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. Let your steadfast love, O Lord, be upon us even as we hope in you.
Ashamed. In your righteousness, deliver me and rescue me. Incline your ear to hear me and save me. Be a rock of habitation to which I may continually come. You have given commandment to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress.
I'll raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I'll raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. Yeah, I'll raise a hallelujah. My weapon is a melody. I raise a hallelujah, 'cause heaven comes to fight for me.
I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm, louder and louder, gonna hear my praises roar up from the ashes. Hope will
I'll raise a hallelujah. with everything inside of me. I'll raise a hallelujah. I will watch the darkness flee. In the middle of the mystery, yeah. I'll raise a hallelujah. There you've lost your hold on me, yeah. I'm gonna sing in the middle of the storm, louder and louder, gonna hear my praises grow. Come on, sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Let's sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Let's sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Oh, let's sing a little louder.
Sing a little louder.
Well, let's sing a little louder.
In the presence of my enemy.
Well, let's sing a little.
Dear Lord, I pray for our community, this area. I pray for our church and for Harrisonburg, the surrounding area. And I also pray, Lord, for Virginia at large and for the whole United States and the whole world, Lord. I pray that you'd be with everyone. You'd be with the Christians around the world and everyone else during this coronavirus time. And God, I pray you provide for their needs. And God, I pray that this opportunity will be a great time for revival, a great time for pouring out your spirit upon all people, and that all people would turn to you, Lord, especially during this crisis. And God, I pray for our leaders. I pray specifically for our governor and for the president and everyone else who's making decisions, especially regarding coronavirus and moving forward in the economy, God. And I pray that you would give him wisdom and discernment on how to move forward and make wise decisions. And God, I pray you guide him and let your glory be made known throughout all the governments. Lord, I pray for our church, Lord. May it be a light and hope to shine over the whole area. God, I pray for every single member of the church. God, I pray you to equip us to be the light to shine forth everywhere we go. And Lord God, I pray for our missionaries. Lord, they're still out there fighting the good fight, whether they have had to come home or not. God, I pray specifically for today for Matt and Stephanie Cram and their family and their mission, Hope Haven, Thailand. God, I pray you provide for their needs. And I pray that you would be with the workers there, particularly Kat, who's working with the children there at Hope Haven. And God, I pray you provide for her and equip her to lead these children well. And God, I pray that you provide funding for them all. And I pray you provide for the Crams and their family. And God, I pray that today, as we hear a message, that it would be a blessing to everyone around them, and that you would encourage us today with your words. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to go to the next one.
Thank you. Thank you.
Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not do what I say? Everyone who comes to me and hears my words and acts on them, I will show you whom he is like. He's like a man building a house who dug deep and laid a foundation on the rock. And when a flood occurred, the torrent burst against the house and could not shake it because it had been well built. But the one who has heard and not acted accordingly, he's like a man who built a house on the ground without any foundation, and the torrent burst against it and immediately collapsed, and the ruin of the house was great.
Increases. Well, I don't know why I've disappeared from my screen, but maybe I'm there on yours. I'm not sure. But at least you can listen and hear what I'm saying, hopefully. So I want to pray today for Bruce. I want to pray for the McFarland household. I want to pray for healing. I want to pray for restoration. And I want to... agree with you in that. Also want to pray today for Philip. And so would you just join me as we pray and believe together for healing. So Father, in the name of Jesus, we know that you are the healer. We know that you are our rock of safety, our rock that is secure. We know that we can hide in you. We thank you, Lord, for salvation. And we pray, Father, that in Jesus' name, you would bring protection, healing, restoration. Lord, Bruce has struggled and has been sick for quite some time and is just worn out and exhausted. We pray healing over him in Jesus' name, restoration, protection for his family. We praise God with Bruce and with his family that he has tested and he is not struggling with coronavirus, and we praise you for that. We just pray restoration for him. Father, we pray for Robert and Tamitha and their household. Lord, a lot of people that are just struggling with sickness, we declare healing over their household. We declare healing over their lives, protection over any that are not sick. We also pray for Kobe, who hurt his hand, and we declare, Lord, that you would touch him and that you would heal him. God, we thank you that you are alive and that you are well and that you are moving today. And so in the name of Jesus, we declare healing. We declare, Lord, also over the church today. Lord, I bless the church with the blessings out of Leviticus 26 that say that if we will obey you, if we will keep your commands, I thank you that in Jesus we're hidden. And so we have kept every one of your commands in Jesus. And I declare provision. I declare protection. I declare more than enough. I declare, Lord, victory over the enemy. I declare, Lord, that our generations would be blessed, our generations would be in Jesus. I declare, Lord God, that in every way we receive the blessings that come from you. I pray this over the church in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, let me just thank you again for being here. Again, if you just tuned in, I'm not sure why I disappeared from the screen, but I did. And so I want to invite you to join us tonight. We have a special gathering tonight. And at the end of last year, I felt like the Lord was just calling us to begin working with those that have mental illness issues, either family members or those that are struggling with it. And my goodness, what a time where this has just increased, and the church really needs to step up and step in and be there for people who are struggling with mental illness. And so I want to invite you to be with us. It's going to be on a Zoom call. If you'd like to be a part of that and you don't have the link, message the church or else send me an email, kevin@riveroaksva.org, and I'll be glad to get back with you and have you be a part of that. Tonight we're going to be looking at very specific ways that we as the church can engage with our community and with one another to help and to support with mental health. So I invite you to be a part of that. It's at 7 o'clock tonight. Again, it's via Zoom, and if you want to be a part of that, let us know. All right. Thank you for being with us. God bless you. God bless your day. God bless your families. And I look forward to seeing you the next time we can get together. God bless.